for the Holocaust, its discerning, nauseating trends that took place in Europe in general, and Germany specifically, and seeing evidence of them here amongst us in 2016, here in Israel. After all, there is nothing simpler and easier than hating the foreigner. There is nothing easier and simpler than arousing fears and intimidating. There is nothing easier and simpler than becoming bestial, forging principles and becoming smug. And he went on to say, there's a kind of similarity with the way the Nazis behaved. Well, if anybody on the present definitions which are doing the round deserves to be called anti-Semite, it's of course the Deputy General of the Israeli Defence Forces. And indeed that's been going to happen. He was heavily criticised, I think today or yesterday, by Netanyahu. It's a measure of, in fact, the deep divisions in Israeli society. I follow Israeli archaeology, very fascinated by the way the Zionism has inspired a number of archaeologists who spent 100 years looking for ancient Israel and can't find it. It's always intrigued me. One of them, these archaeologists, on the progressive wing, came to London recently. I went to his lecture and he and I had a cup of tea. And it was fascinating talking to him, and in every possible way, very, very liberal. He called himself a socialist. But he was itching to have a discussion about the present situation. I sensed, after a good discussion, that wasn't a good idea, but he was insistent that we had this discussion. And I told him my views, in a very moderate way I told him my views, and he said, the trouble with you Jewish leftists in Britain, you don't understand something terribly important. That the Palestinians, however originally well-intentioned, have all become Islamic terrorists. Now this was a superficially rational guy, in his profession, certainly very rational, but it's symptomatic of the levels of racism in Israeli society today. And in fact, the Israeli senior officer of the Defence Forces says this is incredibly important, symptomatic of Israeli society. Now, I'm very conscious of the time. I want to move off that onto one very, very important characteristic of the present crisis in the Labour Party, and the baiting of Labour by the media and the right wing, and of course, people have said the Tories, but also many, many right wing Labour MPs. And the media in particular, I want to talk about normally progressive television channel.